Humans have been living alongside, migrating over, frustrated by, and depending on Arctic sea ice for thousands of years. But it was not until after we had landed on the moon 6 times that we had a reliable picture of just how much ice there was and how much it changed from season to season and year to year. Perhaps the first scientific account we have of sea ice is from the Greek explorer Pytheas of Massilia, who sailed north around England and reported reaching a frozen ocean and long summer days when the sun never set. Pre-Inuit people lived and migrated on the ice, and Vikings kept records of sea ice observations as they explored and settled new lands. Since then, many Scandinavian and Russian Pomar peoples have lived with sea ice, and Inuit culture has been intimately tied to the ice for 1,000 years. In the great age of exploration, seafarers like Corte-Real and Frobisher experienced or were thwarted by sea ice as they searched for new passages across the north and riches to exploit. And mapmakers like Mercator gave the sea ice pack its first rough outline. In the 1700s, Mikhail Lomonosov distilled centuries of Russian seafarers' observations into a groundbreaking analysis of the Arctic. More than 100 years later, Fridtjof Nansen intentionally froze his ship into the ice and drifted for 3 years, confirming large-scale circulation of sea ice. In 1878, Adolf Erik Nordenskjold led the Vega expedition through the Northeast Passage, and in 1906, Roald Amundsen made the first transit of the Northwest Passage, sneaking through the ice pack in his ship, the Joa. In 1926, 2 days after Richard Evelyn Byrd attempted the pole in a small aircraft, the airship Norge carried Amundsen and his crew from Norway over the pole to Alaska. Soon after, a slew of scientific research camps migrated on the shifting ice, including 88 Soviet stations, logging more than 100,000 total miles of drift, and the famous American T3 camp on Fletcher's Ice Island, which was maintained for 20 years. And in 1958, the USS Nautilus traveled under the North Pole and the entire ice cap, beginning a new era of submarine mapping of the rugged underside of the ice.
This is Ed Murrow, and this is the canopy of ice that covers the Arctic Ocean, the frozen barrier that throughout history has barred shipping from a body of water 5 times the size of the Mediterranean Sea. Only once, shortly after the turn of the century, has man reached the North Pole by a surface route. No ship has ever reached the pole. Even the most powerful icebreakers are helpless against this frozen barrier.